This is the panel of study of various parameters of single phase transformer trainer. In this panel, let me tell you what the things we will give you. This is a complete panel. This is a MS cabinet box which is rust proof, and there are digital meters on this panel for better accuracy. This is a single phase transformer which is provided externally, which needs to be connected with the wires that are given here. There are terminals on the face of the transformer. As you can see, this is a single phase transformer. This is the primary side, this is the secondary side. In the primary side, the input are 0 and 220 volt. At the secondary side, it is neutral, 115 volt, 200 volt, 220 volt. That is 50%, 89.9% and 100% tapping at the output. Now let us go to the panel. In the panel, there is inbuilt load. This load is 1 kVA. That is the maximum capacity that this transformer can hold. The rating of this transformer is primary volt input 220 volt, output 0, 115, 200 volt, 220 volt, and power is 1 kVA. So 1 kVA translates to 4.25 ampere current, which you will see on this current meter when I will explain you the experiment. I was telling you about the load. This is a load switch which controls these two bulbs. Similarly, every switch controls two bulbs. So if you switch on one L1 load, then you are putting 1/5 current on this transformer. Corresponding to this reading will change. Voltmeter and current meter, that is your output voltage and your output current will change. So these are the things that you will get with this panel. Now let us start with the experiment. So the first experiment that we will do is, we will do study of open circuit test on a single phase transformer. In the next experiment, we will do study of efficiency of single phase transformer. So first of all, this is a single phase variac. It works from 0 to 4 ampere and 220 volt output. So the variable output voltage is coming here. Here we have shorted the neutral of the variac to the neutral of the transformer. First of all, it is very important to understand that with this cable, all the 6 wires as shown here should be connected 1:1 to the panel. Otherwise this panel will not work. If there is any connection, then this transformer will be damaged. So first, how to make sure that we have made the right connections? The neutral of primary voltage should be connected at 0 volt on the single phase transformer. The 220 volt output should be connected to the primary winding, 220 volt. Similarly, the neutral of the secondary volt winding should be connected at 0 volt secondary winding. 115 volt should be matched to 115 volt from the transformer to the panel. Similarly, 200 volt and 220 volt. Right now, I am doing the experiment on 220 volt using this. Wherever this will go, according to that, the transformer will work. So, what I have done is, this is my voltmeter, current meter, voltmeter, current meter, and digital wattmeter. This is my primary voltmeter, which will measure my voltage at the primary of the transformer. This is my primary current meter, which will measure the drop in the primary winding of the transformer. Similarly, this is my secondary voltmeter and secondary current meter, which is connected between the, taken the input from the 220 volt transformer. Then the second leg is going to a current meter, and then this leg is going to the load. All the 10 bulbs are connected in parallel, and there are the two terminals that are coming at the output. I think you must have understood the connection diagram by now, or if you, there is an issue, the complete connection diagram is given in the manual. So let us switch on the panel. Before switching on the panel, make sure that all the terminals are tight. There should be no loose hanging wire, otherwise it may cause electric current. So to provide any mishappening, make sure that all the terminals are tight. And this variac should be zero so that there is no initial load on the transformer. So let me switch on the panel. Let the current meter and the wattmeter settle down. It will take hardly 5 seconds. Now when all are showing 0,0, then you can start the experiment. You should set this voltmeter to line voltage, that is 220 volt. Now that I have set it to 220 volt, you can see my output is almost similar, only 1.5 volt difference. Now if you want to see the different tapping working, then you just have to remove this. If you want to see the tapping working, then I am a professional, I can do it live, but you should not do this. First you should make it variac zero, then take this wire, connect to 200 volt, then again set it to 220 volt, as you can see I have set it to 230 volt and there I am getting almost 200 volts. This is the 89.99% tapping. Again I will repeat the same experiment, but I will change the output tapping of the transformer. Now I have used 115 volts. Now what I should expect is I should get 50% voltage of whatever I am giving at the primary. Now you can see I have set it to 212 and exactly 50% output it is coming here. This experiment can also be done to calculate the voltage ratio test of the transformer, what I have just shown you. Now again I will repeat and perform the open circuit test. In the open circuit test of the transformer, what we do is we apply 220 at the primary of the transformer and we do not switch off on any load at the output, and then we note down the current and the voltage. The current will always be zero, but the no circuit voltage is important, which is almost similar to the input voltage. That is very important. Now we have performed the open circuit test. To perform the load test and calculate the efficiency, what we will do is we will switch on this load. Now what you have to note down is V1, I1, V2, I2, where V2 and I2 are the secondary voltage, secondary current. V1, I1 is the primary voltage, primary current. With every switching of the load 1, you have to note down these 4 parameters. Again, as you can see, the current will double here. Whatever current that I was getting in 200 watt, at 400 watt it gets doubled. At 600 watts, again it gets tripled 4 times and 5 times. Now it is very important to see here that this is the maximum allowed current of this transformer, and we should not apply load more than this rated current on this transformer for very long time. It will damage the transformer. the bulb that we have used are 10 bulbs of 100 watts. I repeat, 10 bulbs of 100 watt. If you do not have 100 watt bulb, you can also use 5 200 watt bulb. Then also this panel will work. This is the complete working of the single phase transformer trainer.